guys. I'm Tom Phillips, and welcome to Five Things. This past year has featured many up-and-coming WWE superstars like Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose, and Bray Wyatt taking the main event spotlight. It's a major accomplishment to earn that final spot on a pay-per-view, but that's not what today's show is all about. Instead, we're featuring five superstars who you won't believe main evented a WWE pay-per-view. After The Undertaker won the WWE Championship at WrestleMania 13, he literally took on a new challenger every month. The Deadman battled opponents like Mankind, Bret Hart, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Vader, and Farouk? Better known as Ron Simmons, the WWE Hall of Famer was a former WCW champion. This world title match took place much later in Farouk's career. With the Nation of Domination by his side, the former Florida State defensive tackle almost walked away with the WWE Championship. Who doesn't love the suspense of a mystery partner? Well, besides everyone who attended No Way Out of Texas. With Shawn Michaels suffering from a back injury, he needed a last-minute replacement in his eight-man tag team main event. Out of everyone that WWE could choose from, Savio Vega was the lucky tag team partner alongside The Game, Triple H, and the New Age Outlaws. Vega had no prior relationship with any of his partners, as the Caribbean superstar was last seen leading Los Boricuas to battle against the Disciples of Apocalypse. Still, it was like a preview of the DX Army. Only substitute Savio for X-Pac. There's no doubt that the Junkyard Dog is one of the most beloved superstars from the 80s. In 1985, at the Wrestling Classic Tournament, JYD defeated the Iron Sheik and Moondog Spot to make it to the tournament final. There, he defeated Macho Man Randy Savage in the main event of the show. This was both JYD's biggest victory in WWE and also the only time the Hall of Famer ever main evented a pay-per-view. To put it nicely, Heath Slater's win-loss record over the last few years is spotty. While he's picked up some huge wins over the years, it's safe to say he won't be challenging The Undertaker at this year's WrestleMania. Yet, sure enough, he was part of SummerSlam's 2010 main event. It's already been 5 years since the Nexus debuted and had their big showdown against Team WWE at SummerSlam. Although the Nexus was on the losing end of the match, Heath Slater had the most impressive showing, defeating both Edge and Chris Jericho. Vengeance 2006 featured Randy Orton facing Kurt Angle, Ric Flair battling Mick Foley, and Rob Van Dam versus Edge. But the main event somehow included the Spirit Squad. D-Generation X had recently reformed, and Mr. McMahon pitted them against all five cheerleaders in a handicap match. It's no surprise that Shawn Michaels and Triple H shut up and defeated the entire team in their main event reunion bout. Well, at least one of the cheerleaders deserved to be there. You never know who might creep into the upper echelon of a WWE main event. Still, everyone on today's list is very surprising, be it a dog or cheerleader or a wannabe rocker. I'm Tom Phillips, and if you were surprised today, wait until next week when we reveal five forgotten Intercontinental Champions.